कॉक्साकी वायरसेस। द कॉक्साकी वायरसेस बिलोंग टू द पिकोर्ना विरिडे फैमिली एंड द सब फैमिली एंटरो वायरसेस। दे हैव सिंगल स्टैंडर्ड आरएनए एज द न्यूक्लियर मटेरियल एंड दे आर नॉन एनवेलप्ड वायरसेस। द कॉक्साकी वायरसेस बिलोंग टू पिकोर्ना विरिडे फैमिली एंड द सब फैमिली एंटरो वायरसेस। दे हैव सिंगल स्टैंडर्ड आरएनए and they are non-enveloped viruses. The characteristic feature of the Coxsackie viruses are they infect only the suckling mice, but they do not infect the adult mice. So they infect only the suckling mice. There are two groups of Coxsackie viruses based on the pathological changes produced in the suckling mice. The two groups are Coxsackie group A and Coxsackie virus group B. Based on the neutralization test, the Coxsackie group A virus is further of 24 types and the Coxsackie group B virus is further of 6 types. All the 6 types of Coxsackie B virus share common complement fixing antigen. So two groups of Coxsackie viruses A and B. A has 24 types and B has 6 types. When the Coxsackie A viruses are inoculated into suckling mice, they produce generalized myositis and flaccid paralysis, which then progresses to death of the mice in approximately 1 week. Whereas the Coxsackie B virus, when inoculated into suckling mice, produces patchy focal myositis, spastic paralysis, necrosis of brown fat, and often it can also cause pancreatitis, hepatitis, myocarditis and encephalitis. The Coxsackie group A viruses produces generalized myositis and flaccid paralysis, whereas group B produces patchy focal myositis and spastic paralysis. Host range and cultivation. Isolation of Coxsackie viruses is by inoculation into suckling mice. The inoculation route is intracerebral, subcutaneous and intraperitoneal routes. All Coxsackie B viruses grow well in monkey kidney tissue cultures, whereas only type 7 and type 9 out of the 24 types of group A viruses grow well in monkey kidney tissue culture. Next, coming to the clinical features. Clinical features produced by group A Coxsackie viruses. First is herpangina. Herpangina is also called as vesicular pharyngitis. This is common in children where there is severe febrile pharyngitis with headache, vomiting and pain in the abdomen. Febrile because there is fever, and this is common in children causing febrile pharyngitis with headache, vomiting and pain in the abdomen. The characteristic lesions produced in herpangina are small vesicles on the fauces and posterior pharyngeal wall which break to form ulcers. The next disease caused by Coxsackie group A viruses is aseptic meningitis. It is caused by most of the group A viruses and also all the group B viruses. So group A viruses also called aseptic meningitis, and there is presence of maculopapular rash. Next is hand, foot and mouth disease, known as HFMD, hand, foot and mouth disease. Here there is exanthematous fever, exanthematous because there is skin involvement and there is fever. This affects mainly young children, characterized by clusters of papulovesicular lesions on the skin and oral mucosa. Skin of the hand and foot and the oral mucosa is involved. So this is called as hand, foot and mouth disease. So this clusters of papulovesicular lesions on the skin and oral mucosa. This is caused most commonly by Coxsackie A16, A9 and B123. This is a benign illness and it usually resolves in 1 to 2 weeks. Next, the coxsackie group A viruses also cause minor respiratory infections similar to the common cold. So these are caused by the types A10, A21, A24 and B3. These are the diseases caused by coxsackie group A viruses. Now coming to the group B. The group B viruses causes Bornholm disease, B for B. So group B viruses causes Bornholm disease, also called as epidemic myalgia or pleurodynia. The Bornholm disease is a febrile disease with sharp piercing pain in the chest and the abdomen. So group B causes the main is Bornholm's disease, B for B, in which there is fever with sharp piercing pain in chest and the abdomen. Other diseases caused by group B viruses are myocarditis and pericarditis. Inflammation of the myocardium and inflammation of the pericardium of the heart. This is most common in newborns and it has high fatality, that is high death rate. Sometimes it can also cause disease in older children and adults. Next is juvenile diabetes. This is most commonly caused by Coxsackie B4 infection. The juvenile diabetes is caused by Coxsackie B4 infection. The group B viruses also can cause orchitis, that is inflammation of testis, and transplacental and neonatal transmission is also possible. This results in serious disseminated disease, which includes hepatitis, meningoencephalitis, and adrenocortical involvement. The transplacental and neonatal transmission is also seen with Coxsackie group B viruses, resulting in serious disseminated diseases including hepatitis, meningoencephalitis, and adrenocortical involvement. And the group B viruses also cause post-viral fatigue syndrome. Now, coming to the lab diagnosis of Coxsackie group viruses. Firstly, animal inoculation is performed. The virus is isolated from the lesions or the feces. And it is isolated by inoculation into suckling mice by intracerebral, subcutaneous or intraperitoneal methods. But the main thing is the tissue culture and zero diagnosis are not very useful in case of diagnosing Coxsackie viruses. This is because in tissue culture, all the serotypes do not grow well in cell lines and the serodiagnosis is not useful due to the existence of several antigenic types. The last is epidemiology. The Coxsackie viruses primarily inhabit alimentary canal, that is gastrointestinal tract, and it spreads by fecal-oral route, that is through ingestion. The Coxsackie B viruses causes epidemics every 2 to 5 years and the most commonly affected are young infants. The Coxsackie viruses primarily inhabits the gastrointestinal tract, spreads by fecal-oral route, and the Coxsackie B viruses causes epidemics every 2 to 5 years and the young infants are the most commonly affected. This is about Coxsackie viruses. Thank you.